Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Shreyasa Vijay. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 30th of July. Indian Prime Minister virtually inaugurates Mauritius Supreme Court building. Salon owners demand lifting of coronavirus restrictions in Pakistan's Karachi. And U.S. envoy Khalilzad meets Afghan leaders ahead of Eid ceasefire. And now for all the details. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi and his Mauritius counterpart Pravind Kumar Jugnauth on Thursday jointly inaugurated the new Supreme Court building in Port Louis, built with Indian aid. Prime Minister Modi said Mauritius is at the heart of India's approach to the Indian Ocean region.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Thursday said that Mauritius was at the heart of India's approach to the Indian Ocean region while jointly inaugurating the new Supreme Court building of Mauritius in a virtual program with its Mauritian counterpart Pravind Kumar Jugnauth. The Supreme Court building is one of the five projects implemented under a $353 million special economic package extended by India to Mauritius in 2016. The structure is the first India-assisted infrastructure project in the capital of Mauritius.
It was in Mauritius that I had spoken about India's vision of Sagar, security and growth for all in the region. This is because Mauritius is at the heart of India's approach to the Indian Ocean region.
Jugnauth also thanked India for its help in providing medicines, equipment and other assistance in their fight against coronavirus. Mauritius has been the largest source of foreign direct investment for India for more than a decade, with cumulative FDI equity inflows during the period 2000 to 2015 amounting to $91.22 billion, according to India's Foreign Ministry.
Moving on, as many as 52,123 fresh cases of the novel coronavirus were registered in India within a span of 24 hours on Thursday, taking the total cases to 1,583,792. Along with the rise in cases, India's recovery rate from the deadly virus has also increased, pushing government to further relax precautionary restrictions like reopening of gyms and night curfews from early August.
India's single-day increase of coronavirus cases reached 52,123 in last 24 hours, pushing the country's COVID-19 tally to 1,583,792 on Thursday. As the country's recovery surpassed 1 million, Interior Ministry on Wednesday announced Unlock 3.0 starting August 1, but with not too many changes to COVID-19 containment measures. According to the new guidelines, yoga institutes and gyms will be allowed to reopen and night curfews will be lifted. Schools, colleges, metro rail services, cinema halls and international travel will have to remain suspended.
Almost 5 months ho gaye hai, khul raha hai sab kuch, bahut achhi baat hai. Isme bhi hame bahut sare protocols ko follow karne ho gaye, SOPs aayegi. Abhi to filhal guidelines nahi aayi hai government ki. But yes, aayegi to usko sab follow kiya jayega. Hum welcome karte hai is decision ko government ko.
The government has given exemptions for repatriation and other emergency travel for overseas flights under the next step of nationwide unlock. India's countrywide lockdown began on March 25 and was extended to May 31, after which the centre decided for easing restrictions in phases in order to get the economy moving again while observing safety norms.
In news from Pakistan, a massive protest was held recently by beauticians and stylists to demand reopening of their closed businesses amid coronavirus lockdown in Pakistan's Karachi city. The government of Sindh, of which Karachi is the capital, has extended coronavirus lockdown restrictions till August 15. Beauticians and stylists held a massive protest recently to demand reopening of their closed businesses amid coronavirus lockdown in Pakistan's Karachi city. The government of Sindh, of which Karachi is the capital, has extended the province-wide coronavirus lockdown restrictions till August 15. The protesters said, although most businesses have been allowed to operate from 6 a.m. to 7 p.m., salons have still not been given permission to resume operations, due to which they are facing huge losses and people associated with it are staring at an uncertain future.
देखिए, it's been 5 months. हमसे जितना हो सकता था हमने हुकूमत के साथ कोऑपरेट करने की कोशिश की है, लेकिन अब मामलात बिल्कुल बर्दाश्त से बाहर हो गए हैं. जैसे बाकी इदारों को प्रॉपर एसओपीज के साथ खोलने का राइट दिया गया है, वैसे हमें भी राइट मिलना चाहिए कि हम प्रॉपर एसओपीज को फॉलो करते हुए ओपन हो.
घर को चलाना बहुत मुश्किल हो रहा है. बिल, इलेक्ट्रिक बिल और सारी चीज़ें, ये सारी रिकवर नहीं हो पा रही हमारी.
As of Thursday, Pakistan reported 277,402 confirmed cases of coronavirus with 5,924 deaths so far. Pakistan's already fragile economy had only just been moving towards stability when the health crisis struck. Experts fear that the pandemic's economic fallout will considerably derail the country's recovery process. Pakistan government will celebrate Tiger Force Day on August 9 by conducting a nationwide tree plantation drive, Prime Minister Imran Khan has said. The aim of the drive is to plant record number of trees in a single day.
Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan has announced that August 9 would be celebrated as Tiger Force Day, when Corona Relief Tiger Force volunteers will lead a plantation campaign across the country. In a television speech, Khan said that Tiger Force Day aims to set a record of planting the highest number of trees in a single day in the history of Pakistan. In March, following the outbreak of COVID-19 in Pakistan, PM Imran Khan announced the formation of a Tiger Force spearheaded by volunteers to help official institutions combat the pandemic.
आपको पता है कि हमने 10 अरब दरख्त लगाने हैं इंशाल्लाह 2023 तक. हमारे 10 लाख रजिस्टर्ड रजाकार हैं जिनको हम टाइगर्स कहते हैं. इनसे इन सबको आप सबको मैं ये कह रहा हूँ कि 9 अगस्त को आपने ये लीड करनी है, आपने क्यादत करनी है शजरकारी की. इसमें नौजवान, हमारी स्कूल के स्टूडेंट्स सब ने शिरकत कर.
Khan said there are reasons like increasing population, global warming and climate change, which is why plantation at a massive level has become inevitable for Pakistan. Initiated in 2018, the campaign 10 Billion Trees Tsunami aims to fight the effects of climate change by planting over 10 billion trees across the country during the current government's five-year tenure.
In news from Afghanistan, U.S. Special Envoy Zalmay Khalilzad held meetings this week with Afghan leaders on intra-Afghan talks and the implementation of the U.S.-Taliban peace deal. This comes ahead of the Eid al-Adha ceasefire between Taliban and the Afghan government, which starts on Friday. U.S. Special Envoy Zalmay Khalilzad has arrived in Kabul, where he is meeting with Afghan leaders ahead of the Eid al-Adha ceasefire, which starts on Friday, said government officials. In his meeting with President Ashraf Ghani, the two discussed an extension of the ceasefire and a reduction in violence, the start of direct talks, and also the prisoner exchange, the presidential palace said in a statement. Khalilzad also met with Abdullah, where they discussed the completion of the prisoner swap, reduction in violence, intra-Afghan talks and ceasefire, Abdullah's office said in a statement. Members of the High Council of National Reconciliation have said that Khalilzad's trip is aimed at holding discussions with the Afghan political leadership about the intra-Afghan talks and the implementation of the US-Taliban peace agreement, which was signed in Doha on February 29th. Meanwhile, a Taliban spokesman, Sohail Shaheen, in a tweet on Wednesday said the group will release the remaining prisoners of the Afghan government by Eid for goodwill, thus completing the total 1,000. India's religious town of Ayodhya is undergoing a huge makeover ahead of Prime Minister Narendra Modi's visit on 5th of August to lay the foundation stone of a temple at a site that was a bone of contention between Hindus and Muslims for decades.
India's religious town of Ayodhya is undergoing a huge makeover ahead of Prime Minister Narendra Modi's visit on 5th of August to lay the foundation stone of a temple at a site that was a bone of contention between Hindus and Muslims for decades and sparked deadly riots. During the beautification drive, the whole town, including Saryu River, banks and bridges, are being cleaned, mounted with colorful lights and painted with religious graffiti. Security parameters have also been ramped up ahead of the Prime Minister's visit.
वर्कर तो काफ़ी लगे हुए हैं, सबकी अपनी अलग अलग की टीम है।
अच्छा।
हमारी टीम में करीब 35 से 40 वर्कर लगे हुए हैं। जैसे कुछ उधर देखिए आप, झाड़ू में लगे हैं, कुछ यहाँ लगे हैं, कुछ घाट पे लगे हैं।
अच्छा।
तो ऐसे हमारे जैसे और लोग हैं काम कराने तो वाले।
India's Supreme Court in 2019 ruled in favor of Hindus to construct a temple on a land in northern Ayodhya town, where a Mughal-era mosque was raised by a Hindu mob in 1992. As many as 2,000 people died on both sides in the riots that followed. Hindus claimed the mosque was constructed on the land after destroying a Ram temple by Mughal Emperor Babur. The Supreme Court, in its verdict, had also asked for a separate 5-acre land separately to be given to Sunni Waqf Board for the construction of a mosque.
Muslims across India and Bangladesh were on Thursday seen preparing for the upcoming festival of Eid al-Adha or Bakrid amid coronavirus concerns. During the festival, Muslims around the world traditionally purchase livestock, and after slaughtering, the meat is distributed to poorer members of the community.
Muslims across India are preparing for the upcoming festival of Eid al-Adha or Bakrid amid coronavirus concerns. The fear of COVID-19 runs so deep that even sacrificial animals were being sold with masks on at some places, creating particular interest among the buyers and passers-by. God sellers said although they have good quality animals this year, but they were still unable to sell them because people don't have much money owing to the prolonged influence of the pandemic.
कि यहाँ गाड़ियाँ जो है क्रॉसिंग नहीं कर पाती थी, इतने लोग आते थे लेने के लिए, और माल भी माशाल्लाह जो है इससे भी अच्छा भी आता था और इस तरह ही आता था, मगर बहुत ज़्यादा लोग जो है भीड़ भड़ाका होता था और अच्छा माल हमारा बिक्री होता था, मगर इस बार जो है देखने में ये आ रहा है कि लगभग कोई तकरीबन इक्के दुके लोग आ रहे हैं, बाकी कोई आ नहीं रहा और इसलिए माल हमारा जो है कम बिक रहा है।
In Muslim majority Bangladesh, people also gathered at cattle markets in Dhaka as the government has relaxed lockdown measures to allow few cattle markets to operate in the capital city. During Eid al-Adha, one of the two most important festivals of Islamic calendar, Muslims around the world traditionally purchase livestock, and after slaughtering, the meat is distributed to poor members of the community.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.